यहाँ इनवाइट करने के लिए और आई कुड एड्रेस यू और यू नो टॉक टू यू एंड शेयर सम ऑफ माय थॉट्स. द फैक्ट इज दैट यस आई एम अ डॉक्यूमेंट्री फिल्म मेकर बट द टाइम्स आर सच दैट वी हैड टू take on other roles, roles that we had not even anticipated for ourselves. And I have been associated with the Not In My Name campaign now for the past 11 months. And I thought that maybe I could share some of the experiences and some of the learnings that we as a very young campaign have gathered along the way through the series of protests that we have organized. The strength of the campaign has been ordinary citizens from across various sections of society who have responded to a call of the conscience and come out on the streets. The critical aspect of dissent is not just about holding an opinion that is contrary to the official or even commonly held view, but of expressing it and making it public. जब तक आप सड़क पे नहीं आएंगे या आप लिखेंगे नहीं उसके बारे में तो जाहिर नहीं करेंगे डिसेंट को, तो एक्चुअली वो जो डिसेंट है, द एक्ट ऑफ डिसेंट, वो मुकम्मल नहीं होगा. डिसेंट डज नॉट नेसेसरली अराइज आउट ऑफ डीप नॉलेज ऑफ पॉलिटिकल थ्योरी और ऑफ द कॉन्टूर्स ऑफ नियोलिबरलिज्म, बट ऑफ द एबिलिटी टू रिकॉग्नाइज राइट फ्रॉम रॉन्ग, truth from lies, fraternity from enmity. Empathy and belief in justice are the nuts and bolts of dissent. Dissent is above all a call of conscience, and that is what we need today in large doses. We are truly at the most critical point as far as the history of post-independence India is concerned. The system today is snatching away all that makes us human. It is rationalizing hate and the murder of neighbors. It is teaching us to strip people of dignity and their right as citizens of this country. If ever there was need for ordinary citizens to stand up and say no to the powers that be and call on others to reject their politics of hatred, then it has to be now. We are fighting today to remain human, to retain our ability as well as choice to love. We are in dissent because we recognize the pain and the hurt of others. We recognize injustice when we see it. And we recognize that if we don't speak up now, the idea of democracy could die in India. Following the call that some of us in Delhi gave for a protest against targeted mob lynchings on 28 June 2017, last year, more than 33 cities and towns saw protests across the country and even outside under the Not In My Name banner. Now this came as a complete surprise to us, and we didn't even know where the protests were being organized. At many instances, we got to know much, you know, we'd get to know later, or the news would travel to us through social media. We in Delhi were taken completely by surprise by the manner in which the call resonated across so many places. We did not know the organizers of these protests, and we certainly obviously had played no role in their decision to protest. For that matter, except for three people in the organizing team of the Delhi protest who were friends, the others who joined in were strangers to, you know, we were also a bunch of strangers to each other. And following a social media call that I had given initially, people had responded. And people had come together against the injustice and hatred we were witnessing around us. None of us belonged to any group or political party. None of us had any history of organizing political protests. We found ourselves organizing the Not In My Name protest in Delhi simply because, as ordinary citizens, we had waited too long for a protest against mob lynchings to be organized by someone that we could attend. Following the murders of Akhlaq, Pehlu Khan and young Junaid, to name only a few of the victims of targeted mob lynchings, the silence was becoming oppressive. I mean, there was this whole danger that hum apni nazron se na gir jaye agar hum aur chup rahe. So as common citizens, as ordinary citizens, we have to stand up. And I remember, you know, when we were talking about it and some of us had come together following this call, we didn't know who would come. And there was, you know, there was this, some people said, ki koi bhi nahi aayega, hum 10 log hi khade honge. And we said, chalo, 10 log to khade honge. At least, hum to khade the. That, I think, is the call of conscience that we all have to follow for ourselves. I mean, and so we decided as ordinary citizens that if no one would organize a protest against the intolerable, we would. Obviously, there were ordinary citizens across India who felt the same and saw the flowering of political protests against the hatred being spawned by the RSS regime. Having said that, we don't really know why the Not In My Name protest spread in the manner it did. We don't know why the form of protest appealed to people. But we do know that we took certain decisions at the outset that made it easy for people to identify with the mode of protest. One of the earliest decisions taken by the Not In My Name protest went completely against common held wisdom that the way out to counter RSS and its common agenda is never to take the M word. Musalman mat boliye. We were forewarned that to say Muslim would be like showing a red rag to people. Immediately, an entire compendium of whataboutry would be thrown at us. Ignoring the same advice, we spoke of targeting killings of Muslims. We placed the right to life, to equality, to religion and belief of Muslim citizens at the center of the 28th June protest. How could we not? While it is no doubt true that Dalits, Adivasis, minorities across board, women and the poor are suffering equally at the hands of the RSS regime, it is equally true that mob lynchings in the name of beef have been primarily targeted at Muslims. The other wisdom that we were imparted was to approach organizations that could arrange for their cadres to join and lead the protests. We, however, decided to make it into a citizens' protest. The protest would provide the space for citizens to not only be present, but also be part of organizing and taking it forward. The campaign would speak for citizens of India, irrespective of their religion, caste, denomination, gender, sexual orientation. We felt that while several political parties and organizations have been voicing their concern, well, albeit very feebly, on the fast deteriorating communal situation in the country, citizens were not coming out on the streets to voice their anger, dismay, grief, and disagreement with what many of us understand as an assault on the Indian Constitution. The Constitution is the document that the people of India gave to themselves. It promises the right to life, equality, and the freedom of religion and belief to all citizens of India, and is the charter that holds this country together. Political parties and organizations have a critical role to play in the political field, but they are not the only ones who have a stake in the Indian Constitution or the democratic process. We believe there's a crying need for a political presence and articulation of and by the citizens of India that strengthens democratic values and practices without being limited by the imperatives of electoral politics. It is from this position that we took the decision to welcome everyone to the protest, including political formations, but without the political party banners and logos. And I know that there was, you know, there's also mooted criticism about that, but I think that was the decision we stand by, because that allowed for the largest sense of ownership of the protest by people, cutting across, you know, whatever, so that the protest did not get identified with any particular group or any particular political formation. The question, however, remained of would people come out and self-organize in the absence of any core leadership and direction. We were not leaders, and we had no ambitions of becoming leaders. So then, how does protest take place, and We decided, therefore, on a set of principles that would be our guiding spirit rather than individual leaders. The first principle, which I have already stated, was that the protest would be a citizens' protest, sends all party and organizational banners. The other major principle that we put into place was about the media. As news of the protest first spread and more citizens across the country began to organize around the Not In My Name poll, we were besieged by TV channels to participate in their regular debates. Some of them asked to run their programs from the protest site. Part of our media strategy was to inform the TV channels that we were neither interested in coming to debate political party representatives, nor would we be part of any panel from the protest site that had party spokespersons. The channels were quick to accede to this insistence. This decision was taken because we felt that we did not need to respond to BJP spokespersons or their stand-ins in TV debates, when we were responding to them on the streets through our protest. We also felt that the lazy debate show, the mainstay of TV channels, is not only meaningless cacophony, but it is also representative of the dismal political scenario, where the most serious issues facing Indian people get gridlocked into a gladiatorial arena. We also did not wish to share TV space with non-BJP political representatives. We did not want to be caught in the BJP versus the opposition manipulation of every important issue confronting us today, where the same set of political positions are repeated over and over again. The same actors appear across several TV channels while the issue at hand takes a backseat and everything boils down to defending political fortresses and ideological positions. If we were going to be on TV, then it had to be on our terms. Outside the daily drama of the BJP versus the opposition tagline, can there be a media space for a politics that is not emerging from the offices of any political party or organization? That is the question we were trying to answer through our media strategy. And last, we also took a decision to boycott television channels Times Now, ZTV and Republic. This, of course, for very obvious reasons, I mean, and informed them that our organizing team would not appear in any show run by them. The third principle that we put in place was that the protest would run on individual contributions, the details of which would be shared in all the meetings of the campaign. No funds would be solicited or accepted from political parties, NGOs or other organizations, and all the expenses of the campaign would be met solely by individual contributors. And this has been our policy for the past 11 years. Another major principle that we put in place was that we would share all our design and artwork and material with anyone who wanted to organize protests, regardless of whether they were using the Not In My Name banner or they were not using it. But if they were organizing, citizens' protests, they were most welcome to use whatever material that we had generated. While the 28th June protest was mostly organized under the banner of the Not In My Name, the last series of protests, that is just about a month back, that sprang up in dozens of places across North, East and Western India, post the Unnao and Kathua rape cases, were held under different banners. However, they were mostly self-organized by groups of people or individuals, utilizing the core principles and ideas of the citizens' rights. The Not In My Name campaign is an experiment with a different form of politics that enables citizens to self-organize and not depend on any one central core for decision-making or action. The form of protest is another important aspect that the campaign has constantly engaged with for the past 11 months. It was of central concern even as we were preparing for the first Not In My Name protest on the 28th of June, and has remained the most discussed aspect at all planning meetings of subsequent protests. Dissent gets its meaning from form, and form becomes the vehicle for dissent to circulate, become part of the imagination, and thereby of inspiration. One example that I would like to share is from the 100 protests that the campaign organized right across the Delhi NCR region on the 10th of September 2017 against the politics of hatred. The idea came out of the realization that although thousands had gathered at Jantar Mantar on 28th June, the campaign now needed to reach the nooks and crannies of Delhi, its neighborhoods and mohallas, you know, to move out of the echo chamber that I think Rajdeep was also referring to. And how do you move out of the echo chamber? You move out, you literally move out, you physically move out. And you go to the mohallas and neighborhoods. We went from across to the resettlement areas, to Old Delhi, to Mehroli, to, you know, other areas. And within Gurgaon itself, there were two such protests organized, one within Sikandarpur village and one in the, you know, where the posh apartment complexes are. So, and actually the protests were organized by, you know, getting the local people involved, of them claiming ownership of the protest, of making it theirs, and from there moving it. So actually in every place in those 100 protests, it had a very different color, it had a very different form, and that was really very interesting because it was being informed, even whether within the same city, by local circumstances, by local concerns. One of the actions of 10th September was rolled out by a group of dancers who moved north to south and east to west on the metro line. At more than 30 places, they simply stood holding hands on the streets or on busy crossroads, and soon passerbys and onlookers began joining. A long chain of people would thus be formed, holding hands and offering resistance to the politics of faith, silent. The people would be intrigued, and then they would start saying, kya bhai sahab, kya hai, and you know, so then the dancers would start explaining and offer a hand, and that person would join. And so this long chain started forming. A simple but an emotive coming together of dissent on the streets. The most important aspect of the campaign has always been to make the protest public, to inspire people to step out on the streets and to take charge of the public space and be heard. And that is what we have been trying to do, even in the context of the Gurgaon Namaz issue that has come up in the recent past. I mean, I'm sure all of you are aware that, you know, there is this ongoing campaign by the Sanyukt Hindu Sangharsh Samiti, which claims to be an umbrella body of the local units of various Hindutva groups, including the Bajrang Dal, Vishwa Hindu Parishad, Shiv Sena. And so they have been, they started on the 20th of April, actually. They began this thing of disrupting namazes by disrupting a public namaz in Basirabad. And then they followed it up and by giving press statements and, you know, the usual aggressive bullying. Subsequently, on the 4th of May, again there was a disruption of about 10 namaz sites, which they themselves made that claim very proudly. And so there was, you know, there's been attempts there of a citizens, of getting the citizens together, of countering this politics of hatred. The question that we have been trying to address in Gurgaon is how do we get people who don't agree with the attacks on the namaz to step out into public spaces and self-organize, especially people who have no background of, you know, taking part of even attending a political protest. So then one has to move within those states. A meeting was called by the Not In My Name campaign to discuss the issue and plan an intervention. And that meeting saw more than 90 people cramped inside a living room of a house. And those in attendance were truly the face of Gurgaon, from trade union activists to corporate house executives to retired defense force officers to the local imams. The group has now rechristened itself the Gurgaon Nagrik Ekta Manch, and is busy on an everyday basis gathering information about Friday Namaz sites, meeting the administration, and planning opportunities for people to step out and come together during the observing a show of solidarity, even of organizing iftars. It seems, you know, when it was first suggested, it seemed like a throwback from, you know, the powerless past. You know, you have iftar. But in the highly polarized atmosphere of a place like Gurgaon at the moment, even that seems like a big step and a radical step. Finally, the important point is not whether the Not In My Name campaign survives or not, or whether there is a future for it. What we feel is important is that we should be able to reach into Indian politics, a new force of the citizen's voice that is always ready